Get ready to match the stars. Richard Deacon, Red Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Addie Duke Astin, from The Price is Right, Bob Barker, and Fannie Flagg, as we play the star-studded big money match game, PM. And now, here's the star of match game, PM, Gene Rammer.
Johnny, yo.
Thank you very much.
I love you. Thank you for joining us here on Match Game PM. You're going to have a wonderful time because the loonies are here.
No, they're out there.
Oh, they're out there, yeah. No, you are a you are the most beautiful celebrities on this stage.
You're
and
right.
I ask you to join me in welcoming Bill Copeland and Janie Severson. I greet you both. Welcome you. Thank you for showing up here. I'd like to find out a little bit about each of you. Janie, we'll begin with you, if you please.
I'm a native Californian. I now live in San Diego, and I work as a flight attendant, and I'm really happy to be here.
Well, we're happy to have you.
Thank you.
Has a great smile, doesn't she?
Sure does.
Yes, indeed. Good luck to you, Janie. And what about you, Bill? Where are you from and all that?
I'm from the big town of Laverne.
Out in Laverne. The
same, yeah, Laverne. You've heard of that, haven't you?
No, I haven't heard of that, Bill. I'll level with you.
It's right near Shirley.
But I'm a...
Now, I was hoping nobody would say that.
I couldn't help it. I had to go
Brett, you mustn't go for the obvious. Now, you know that.
It's my job.
Now, I'm sorry for the interruption. Go ahead,
No
Bill.
Problem. I'm a sales manager for an automotive parts distributor out in San Bernardino.
Yep.
Married.
Yep.
Have two good-looking kids, Heidi and Holly. Hi, monsters. It's about it. We used to fly together.
Really?
Oh, mm-hmm.
Are you a pilot?
As it turns out, no.
Well,
she's
I don't
a
hear
stewardess.
Any more about it.
He was a passenger.
Oh, he was a passenger. Oh, all right. Now, I'll point out to you here in all candor on Match Game PM, each of you will have three opportunities to match as many of the creatures from the Dark Lagoon as you possibly can. And the one who's done that most often at the end of the third round will be the winner. And then that person will go on to play the big money super match, which can pay off over $20,000. Are you ready for that? Howie. All right, Janie, I'll ask you to go first. You may have A or B.
I'll take A.
A? Janie wants A, she says. The psychiatrist said to his nurse.
Pardon me?
The psychiatrist.
Thank you.
Psychiatrist said to his nurse, "You remember that patient who married his raincoat?" Well, now he's cheating on the raincoat. He's seeing his blank on the side. Aren't you glad you came?
Yes, I am. I'm always glad to be here, particularly at night.
Yeah.
I don't get out much.
Oh, well, they must let you out more often at night. Now, Janie, the psychiatrist said to his nurse, "You remember that patient who married his raincoat? Well, now he's cheating on the raincoat. He's seeing his blank on the side.
His umbrella.
His umbrella." Okay. She said umbrella.
And I said rubbers.
Okay. Galoshes, rubbers, all that sort of thing. What do you say to that?
What did you ask me?
What did I ask you? He's not cheating. He's cheating on the raincoat. He's seeing his blank on the side.
Get his nurse, will you please? He can't even speak today. Umbrella!
Oh, good! You knew what I asked you.
I was just funning you.
Yeah, I know you were.
Trying to make your life a living hell.
And you sure do. Yes, sir.
Some people got Paul Lynde, we got her. Umbrella.
Okay, Janie, we have two. What do we get from Batty Duke Astin?
Bumbershoot.
A bumbershoot. That really surprises me. I thought everybody was going to say galoshes and stuff like that.
Well, I'm surprised they're saying, how can we go on? Johnny Olson hasn't said come on down to anybody yet.
I know that isn't so. Now, cut that out.
When he sees his answer, he'll probably say, get on out. No, I went to the wrong end. I didn't say umbrella. I said galoshes.
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 Okay.
Just a moment. Just a moment. Those
galoshes
of you who
is
watch
a good response.
Price is Right know that's the first mistake I've ever made.
Right. Today.
Today.
Before Fannie shows her answer, I would like America to take note of her spelling. I happened to see it before it was put up.
Now, you know, spelling doesn't count here. It's the answer that's important.
Well, gasloshes.
Now, wait a minute.
That's Hungarian when you sneeze. Gasloshes.
Na zdravje. Are you ready, Bill?
I'll take B.
Oh, thank you.
Bill's ready.
I am surrounded.
But can he spell galoshes?
He can't. Marvin said, the strangest thing just happened. I got an obscene phone call from my blank.
Who said it?
Marvin.
Marvin.
Marvin said, the strange thing just happened. I got an obscene phone call from my blank. All right, Bill, are you ready? Marvin said, the strangest thing just happened. I got an obscene phone call from my blank.
From my mother.
My mother. He went all the way with that.
He did.
Sick.
You should see my minister.
Oh, the minister.
Well, I'm a deacon. I can say that.
Oh, cute.
Yes.
Cute. I don't know what's come over me. I think I've gone crazy.
Uh-oh.
Mommy.
Mommy. One for you, Bill.
I said wife.
Wife or mother would be the two good answers. Don't feel bad about it, Charles. You mustn't cry. Remember. Patty, what do you say? Got an obscene phone call from my...
My mother, the clergyman.
The clergyman. All right. Score remains at 3-1,
When he said
Bob.
Mother... Patty said, that's sick. The audience loved it. What does that make them?
Yes.
Huh? But I must admit that you're right. Wife is a good answer.
Yes, wife and mother would be the two somewhat definitive answers. What do you say to that?
Well, it's a religious show, if nothing else. Priest. Did it again.
Yes.
E-I.
I before E, except after C. All right. So where are we here? 3-1 the score at the end of round one. Round two coming up a little bit. Watch this. Here we go to round two. And Shane, since you're ahead, we're going to ask you to go first. You may have A or B.
I'll stick with A again.
Okay. Richard, you play. Bob and Fanny. The rest of you, you may lay out, if you please.
Okay.
Bucktooth Betty is so bucktooth.
How bucktooth is she?
That's a hard one, isn't it? She's so bucktoothed, yesterday her husband used her teeth as a blank.
That hurts me. Think about it, hurt me. Doesn't that hurt your little two feet?
A little bit, yeah.
So
okay.
What?
Go stick it in.
You don't have to hear me.
Bucktooth Betty.
Why, Matt?
Bucktooth Betty is so bucktooth. Yesterday, her husband used her teeth as a blank.
As a can opener.
Can opener. She said can opener.
And I did too.
Aha! Four for Janie. Bob, we come to you.
Well, I'm in a hot streak. I said saw.
A saw? Now, that would be good.
What?
Now, wait a minute.
No!
Wrong.
Well, now, wait a minute.
That happens to be a good answer. Saw happens to be good. Because you see, if the teeth were sticking out here, he could take her head and put a 2x4 there and go.
That was precisely what I had in mind when I wrote this. Yeah. These people are Art Linkletter fans.
Right.
I can tell that. And I may not stay.
Please do. Now, Fanny, what have you got for us?
Yes, my dear. Well, I have can or bottle opener.
Can or bottle opener. Okay. Now, Fanny Flagg said.
Uh-oh.
I finally made big in
Hollywood. Do it. Give it to me. I'll do it.
You do Fanny Flagg?
Sure.
All right, let's hear your Fanny Flagg.
Fanny Flagg said, I finally made it big in Hollywood. Rome's Chinese Theater wants me to come over and stick my blank in Wimp with the Man.
Mm-hmm. Leave her alone.
Oh, I love her so.
She's always nice to me in public.
Are you ready? Here we go. Fannie Flagg said, I finally made it big in Hollywood. Grauman's Chinese Theater asked me to come over and stick my blank in wet cement.
Her Fanny.
My Fanny. I know some of you wanted to go to the other extremity, but he chose Fanny, and that's his right and prerogative.
I go to a different baker, but it comes out the same.
Yes, it does. Buttons. Okay, Charles, you play.
I went for old standby Howard Cosell.
Yes, he is indeed. Okay, what have you got? You got two. All right.
I'm not doing very well this evening. I said boobs.
Says boobalas.
I'd like to see her boobs in Grauman's cement.
Yeah.
I would.
Well, that has been done, hasn't it? Didn't someone do that?
Raquel, what's her face?
Oh, yes, Raquel did it, right.
No, she didn't? I don't think you can do that because you have to take it off. You
know? Oh, yeah, really? Would you like to show us how it's done?
It no. would be the same as putting my feet in.
Oh, all right. Okay, Bob.
If Bill had been sitting as close to Fanny as I am, he too would have said boot.
Yes, right.
Although I almost couldn't say it.
That's a verbal rape, almost.
Now, Miss Fanny, what do you have to say about this, honey?
Well, I'm going into the Pillsbury Bake Off. It's so nice. I'm going to have a grit tart.
No, I have the
grit
tart. They say they want me to put my into the cement.
Yeah, you're
I have
blank.
The perfect answer. My friend Brett's big mouth.
I assume you all took note of the fact that she spelled every word correctly when
not
she gets
bad,
angry.
I write well.
Jane, you're still ahead, so we'll ask you to go first again.
I'll stick with A.
Okay. Who plays?
Bobby.
One
Bobby.
Person.
Oh.
Naturally.
You're the only one.
Right.
Here it is, dummy.
Yeah.
When Fat Phyllis got dressed this morning, her living girdle blanked. Oh, I love this one.
I think he's
awesome. Yeah. When Fat Phyllis got dressed this morning, her living girdle blanked.
I wonder if this audience realizes that when some of these matches do not occur with me, it's the contestant's fault, not mine.
That's right. Yeah.
Just agree
we'll
with
keep
it.
That in
right.
mind.
It doesn't even enter their mind.
Right.
Just agree with him.
Janie, when Fat Phyllis got dressed this morning, her living girdle blanked.
Died.
Died. She is looking for a deceased two-way stretch.
Now, that was the first thing that occurred to me.
It did.
And so I wrote it.
Right. Good for you. All right, Jenny, you got six. Now, Bill, that means the best you can do is achieve a tie. You can tie, however, if you match Charles plus the lower tier, who will now participate in this. Gloria said, my husband, the TV star, has been on television too long. Last night, while we were making love, he stopped for blank. All right. Remember, we've got to match everybody, so think carefully before you respond. Gloria said, my husband, the TV star, has been on television too long. Last night, while we were making love, he stopped for...
A commercial.
A commercial. Got to match everybody. Charles, he said he stopped for a commercial. What do you say to that?
I said the same thing.
Okay. Score's now 6-3. While we were making love, he stopped for?
A word from the sponsor.
A word from the sponsor, another match. 6-4.
I'm definitely in a hot streak. A commercial.
A commercial. Now, you must match Fanny to achieve a tie and stay in the game.
And I was nice to you.
You were. All right.
A commercial.
All right. We do indeed have a tie. 6-6. We'll tell you about a tie right after we tell you about this. All right. Here we go now. We don't have enough time to play our regular tiebreaker, so we're going to play sudden death. That means the first one of you to score a match will be the winner. And we have one tie-breaking question for you. You will write your answers, and then we'll just start with Richard and go across the line, as we usually do. And the first one to come up with the answer that one of you has written, you'll jump up and down or holler or whistle or whatever. Here it is. Presidential blank.
Oh,
Presidential. Blank.
Presidential what?
Presidential blank. You do not write. You don't have to write.
You see, you didn't explain the rules.
All right, here we go. Richard, now remember, as soon as you hear your answer, why, jump up and down and sing Dixie. Hello there, Richard Deacon. Presidential blank.
Sweet.
Presidential sweet.
Wrong.
Splendid.
No, I meant you. That wasn't the answer.
Oh, I see. What do you say to this?
Presidential election.
Presidential election. Neither one of them has that either. Charles?
We could try peanut or... You said what?
Election. You say campaign.
Don't tell him what to say. He's on
his
own.
Well, he'll be here till morning.
Okay, Charles, we need an answer from you now.
Well, don't turn on me.
I am.
Campaign!
Seal is what Bill has. You guys can bleed out if you would, please. Now, Bill, we thank you very much for being with us.
We're
going to send some gifts your way. Bill Copeland, ladies and gentlemen, there he goes. Time now for the Big Money Super Match, when you can win over $20,000. To do that, we have two audience matches for you. I'm going to begin with the first one. We polled the studio audience and said, write down your best answer to this. Mono blank. If you match the answer they wrote down most frequently, you get $500. $250 for matching their second most popular answer, and $100 for matching the third. Three of the six stars are allowed to suggest answers and help you out here.
Okay. Patty?
Patty?
Mononucleosis, only I bet they couldn't spell it.
Mononucleosis?
Brett?
Monorail.
Monorail.
And Bob?
Monologue.
Monologue. You have monologue, monorail, and mononucleosis. Do you want one of those, or would you like to think up one of your own?
I'll go for mononucleosis.
You do?
I don't want it.
Okay, I'm going to give it to you right now. You know how you get it, don't you? Oh, all right. Mononucleosis, let's see the $100 response. Monogram. Let's see if we got it under the $250 number. Monorail is Brett's answer. Last chance for mononucleosis. Slide it. Yeah! You got it. Very good. Okay. You've won $500, which means the least you can be playing for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. We're going to see now how you're going to do with your second audience match. All right, slide it. Blank Lou. All right. Whom do you call on?
Richard.
Richard Water. Deacon. Waterloo. Yeah.
Charles.
Oh, my God. You've got me, sweetheart. You're on your own. There's water.
Oh, wait, I'm on it.
Something's coming to him.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, sure.
They didn't notice that at all, sweetheart. cute, the way you did that. Yeah. Skip to Malou.
Skip to Malou.
Oh, I got one.
Skip to Malou.
Okay, Brett.
Oh, what do Lulu. You?
Lulu.
Lulu no. is back in town.
No, she was only kidding. She's a Lulu.
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 Lulu. You're a Lulu.
Waterloo and Skip to Malou are the three. Which one would you like, or one of your own?
I'll go for Waterloo.
Waterloo is what you want. Maybe see the $100 response. Babaloo. Babaloo, Babaloo, Babaloo. May we see the $250 number? Skip to Malou is up there. I think Waterloo's going to be there. Slide it, Ori. Yeah! Okay. Now. Jamie has won another $500. We multiply that by 10, which makes $5,000. We add the previous $5,000, gives you a total of $10,000. But you can double that. You can play for $20,000 if you have a lucky spin of the wheel. Give it a good spin. It must make one complete revolution. Go. All right, let's see if she's going to play for $10,000 or $20,000. Here it is. Yeah! $20,000. Here we go. Good luck to you, Janie. Are you ready?
Oh, yes.
Here it is. Lois blank. That's L-O-I-S blank. Lois blank.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Now, Janie, he's finished. We ask you to give us the answer that he's given us. If you do that, you get $20,000. Lois
Lane.
Lois Lane. Well, they're with you up there.
Richard, she said Lois Lane will match you for $20,000.
Oh, no.
Richard. A grand total of $21,000 for Janie Severson. Oh, is she a happy lady? Now she's celebrating her own new little business with America. Join us next week for Match Game BM when we'll try to give away more money here. Thank you. I'm Gene Rayburn. Goodbye.
Some contestants will receive a supply of Fabergé organic shampoo, conditioner, cream rinse, and hand and body lotion, all with pure wheat germ oil and honey containing natural and other ingredients. And Health Fit lightweight underwear that... Speaking for Match Game PM, a Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production.